Hey, Bet Buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsy One here. And I said I wasn't going to do it, but I'm going to do it. Another belt, but it's not about the belt. People have asked me to show how to make an opening and closing pouch. When my Bet Buddies ask me to do something and I can do it pretty easily, I might as well. It's simple enough. So let's go over to the table and take a quick little look at a belt and some opening and closing pouches and how to make them. One way to make them. Hundreds of ways to make them. You're going to see one. So here we go. We have an opening and closing pouch, okay? This is leather. I used to have a leather sewing machine. I don't do that anymore. So I'm gonna show you another way because I know a lot of you don't have a leather sewing machine. So let's go up top and I'll show you how this is put together. We can go from there. So here we have the makings of a belt. I have these couple of pieces left over from before. I'm gonna put that together. I have this really cool, I don't know, came off a shoe or something. Figured that could be a thing that you hold in your batarang. I have these, we've seen these before, but I did them thin. Put those together, make one pouch on both sides. I have this, I flatten it out. It's gonna go on there. I have this, I could put on if I want. I have these or anything else, but it's really not about that. It's really about this. I had that piece of leather left over. I used most of it for the backing. And as you see, I didn't have much to work with. So the pouch pretty much dictated the size it was going to be based on what leather I had to work with and the size of the belt underneath it. This is too far up, it should have been down, and this should have come over further. But I don't think I had enough to bring it over further, so I'm just gonna have it like this for today, for today's intents and purposes. And I took and cut the exact pieces on another one. So this is the back, and it loops over like that. This is the front. If you don't have the ability to sew, not a problem. Just take some Zap-A-Gap. Now I'm not gonna do this in front of you, I'm gonna show you what I did, and then I'm gonna put the belt together. I have two that are slightly longer. This leather is kind of warpy, so it's a little bit tricky. Try to get it to where it's mostly straight. Hold it in place. Put a few areas of Zap-A-Gap and tack it. Hold it on there and spritz it. Do the other side and the bottom. Once you've got it on there, you run a bead along the whole thing and really get it in there good. Really let it soak down into the fibers of the leather and spritz it. Then I took and went to the belt sander and just made everything nice and smooth. And I went along the edges after I did that and took a little bit of some leather dye to just give them a little bit feeling of the same type of color. So as I say, I would have liked this to come down further, but I didn't have enough leather. So I'm just showing you. It's actually not that bad because it sticks up a little bit, and if Batman wants to get in it quick, no problem. Just get his fingers under there real quick. But really it should have gone down further and should have laid flatter. So anyway, that is that. I'm gonna do another one exactly like it for this belt, even though I would like to do it better. It's all I had to work with. So then I took my leather tools and selected some snaps, my little cutter thing. I'm sure there's an official term for that, but I don't know what it is. And made my little holes, which I promptly made off center, which I don't know why, because I wasn't talking to you guys. I guess it was just doggone hot. Look at me, I'm sweating again. But for intensive purposes of this, shows you how to do it. You drive these into there and you make your little snaps, put anything down in there that you want to. No stitching required. Open it very easily. Now what I'm gonna do is, just because this is for this purpose of video only, is I'm gonna make the other one have a different closure method. I'm gonna put this together, I'm gonna show you how, I'm gonna put a strap along there, and it's gonna go down further, and it's gonna lift up. The snap will be down here, and this little tab will be there, and it'll lift up. That's the way it is on the TV bat belt, only you don't see the flap on the top. You just assume something opens. Well, you're gonna see the flap, but I'm gonna make one of those for the other one. So it won't be symmetrical, but hey, it's for purposes of showing you different ways, giving you inspiration and saying, hey, I listened. I'm showing you one way to do an opening and closing pouch. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and assemble another one of these, get back with you and show you what it looks like for the finishing process. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1.